Metal Gear Solid 4, the game that has been held hostage by the PlayStation 3 for more than a decade. It was a great experience at the time, but its low resolution and frame rate have not aged very well. While the announcement of the Metal Gear Solid Master Collection Volume 1 has given us hope for a remastered version of MGS4 on other platforms such as the PC, there's no guarantee that it will happen. However, you don't even need to wait for a Volume 2 of the Master Collection to play MGS4 on PC at 4K 60fps. You can do that right now, if you have a strong enough PC. In this video, I'm going to show you how MGS4 runs on RPCS3 emulator, talk about the settings and what kind of PC you'll need. So without further ado, let's get started. One of the main problems with playing MGS4 today is its outdated graphics. The native resolution of 1024x768 on the PlayStation 3 looks very dated. Specifically, the low-resolution shadows are noticeably pixelated, diminishing the immersion of the game's many cutscenes. However, RPCS3 allows you to overcome these limitations. By running the game at native 4K resolution, MGS4 undergoes a stunning transformation. The higher resolution not only emphasizes the details of the character models, but also elevates the visual fidelity of the shadows. The shadow resolution is tied to the game's rendering resolution, so by increasing it, you get shadows that are crisp and immersive, enhancing the overall gaming experience. MGS4's performance on the PS3 was capped at 30fps, with certain areas experiencing drops as low as 20fps. RPCS3 offers the option of unlocking the framerate limit. With the capability to play at 60fps, the game becomes noticeably smoother, offering more responsive controls and a heightened sense of immersion. Reaching that 60fps mark won't be easy though. The complex architecture of the PS3 CPU demands a powerful CPU to achieve optimal performance on RPCS3. For example, an i5-9600K is capable of running the game, reaching 60fps most of the time when the resolution is set to the native resolution of the game on PS3. However, when increasing the resolution to native 4K, the i5-9600K oscillates between 20fps and 60fps most of the time. It does perform better than or on par with the actual PS3 though, even at native 4K. To maintain a consistently smooth experience, a modern CPU with strong single-threaded performance and a large amount of threads is recommended. CPUs with AVX 512 instruction support can further enhance RPCS3's performance. I'll leave a link in the description for a CPU tier list for RPCS3 so you can have an idea of how your CPU performs. In the past, it was necessary to use specialized builds of RPCS3, such as Reg Costa's build, to optimize MGS4's emulation. However, the main build of RPCS3 has integrated these improvements through game patches. Moreover, the main build has received numerous updates over the years that the special builds have missed, which have made it perform better than those builds. The main build also includes a few patches that disable multiple graphical effects to improve performance even further, but I'd say disabling these effects ruins the experience, so I wouldn't recommend it. MGS4's gameplay originally utilized the pressure-sensitive buttons and motion controls on the DualShock 3 controller. The main action that uses pressure sensitivity is throwing a grenade. You switch between underhand throws and overhand throws by holding L1 lightly or firmly. With a controller that doesn't have pressure-sensitive buttons, you'll be stuck on overhand throws, which is not a problem. Another action that uses pressure sensitivity is the chokehold. When grabbing a hostage, you can keep holding them normally by holding R1 lightly, or you can put them in a chokehold by holding R1 firmly. On the modern controller, you'll be putting them in a chokehold instantly every time you grab the hostage. I'd say this is also not a problem, as the game remains perfectly playable, even when you need to grab a certain boss later in the game. Speaking of which, at another point late in the game, you'll be told to use motion controls against a certain boss, but you can rotate the right analog stick instead, and it'll work just fine. So you do not need a PS3 controller to finish this game on RPCS3. You can even use an Xbox controller and you should still be fine. It's important to note that your first playthrough of MGS4 on RPCS3 might involve some waiting. The emulator needs to compile PPU modules as you progress to sections of the game for the first time. You might also experience some stuttering as shaders and SPU modules compile during gameplay. However, this initial inconvenience paves the way for smoother subsequent playthrough. Now let's talk about the settings. Instead of just showing which settings I've used, like I do in every video, I'll discuss the settings in more detail. It's important to note that everything I say is based on my experience with the emulator. I'm not a developer, and I've only used the emulator on my PC, so what I say might not work exactly the same for you. Okay, the first thing you need to do is update the game to version 2.0. That gives you multiple benefits, including better performance and the ability to install the whole game at once. If you don't know how to update the game, I'll leave a link to a guide in the description. With that out of the way, let's start on the CPU tab. You should leave PPU decoder and SPU decoder on recompiler LLVM as it's the fastest option. XFloat accuracy can be set to relaxed, which is also the fastest option. SPU loop detection needs to be disabled on my PC, but it could be because my CPU is limited to 6 threads. If your CPU is more powerful and has more threads, you can try enabling it and see if it improves performance. TSX instructions should probably be set to disabled on most CPUs. SPU block size set to mega is what worked best for my PC. You can try the other options to see if it improved performance for you, but take note that each one of these settings uses different sets of SPU modules. So when you try them for the first time, you'll have to compile modules again. The best number of SPU threads can vary a lot from CPU to CPU, but what worked best for me was 3. You can try changing these numbers and see what works best for you. Now let's move on to the GPU tab. The renderer should always be Vulkan, as it's the most developed renderer on RPCS3 as far as I know. OpenGL should only be used if you have a problem when using Vulkan. Zcol accuracy can be set to relaxed with no problems. I've tried different shader quality settings and I did not find any difference in either performance or image quality, so I just left it on high. Default resolution should be left at 720p even if you want to increase the rendering resolution. To increase the rendering resolution, you need to change the resolution scale setting. I've set it to 375%, which is native 4K for MGS4. The UI uses 720p as a base for calculating the final resolution, but MGS4 does not run natively at 720p. It runs at 1024 by 768. So to get 4K, you need about 375%. As for frame rate limit and VSync, it worked better for me leaving both off on the emulator and forcing them through the NVIDIA control panel. You need to limit the frame rate to 60 FPS, otherwise the cutscenes will play at a faster speed when the FPS goes higher than 60 and the audio will go out of sync. Right color buffers should be enabled to correct visual glitches. If you have a CPU with a lot of threads, enabling multi-threaded RSX might improve performance. Shader mode can be set to async with shader interpreter for the best experience. Now let's quickly check the audio tab. Here the only things of note are the audio out setting, which I recommend setting to QB, and buffering, which should be enabled. If you experience problems with audio stuttering, you can try increasing the buffer duration like I did here. However, keep in mind that audio stuttering is a sign of a weak CPU, and it's likely that you will not be able to resolve it completely. Now let's move to the Advanced tab. There are some important settings in this tab, starting with sleep timer's accuracy, which should be set to use sleep only for better performance. The maximum number of spurs threads setting can affect performance in various ways. On my PC, setting it to 3 or 4 seemed to have the best performance. You can try different values here and see how it runs. If you experience crashes, set it to unlimited. RSX first-in, first-out accuracy can be left on fast for better performance. The RPCS3 wiki states that it helps with its stability, so if you're getting crashes, then you can try setting it to atomic. Driver wake-up delay can also be increased to help with the stability, and from my experience, a value of 40 microseconds seems to be the sweet spot. V-blank frequency is a setting that helps improve performance. Anything between 240 Hz and 600 Hz should give you a good boost. Going higher than 600 Hz doesn't seem to help with performance though. Now there are a couple of settings that the wiki recommends that I'm not sure about. The first one is accurate RSX reservation access, which did not seem to do anything on my PC, but you can try it for yourself. The other one is enabling this library to properly play FMV cutscenes. But in my experience, the FMV cutscenes play just fine without it, and when I enable it, I get horrible stuttering on FMV cutscenes, so I just left it disabled. And that's pretty much it for settings. Remember, these might not work the same on your PC as they did on mine.
You gonna take it or what?
In conclusion, emulating Metal Gear Solid 4 on PC through RPCS3 emulator presents a great opportunity for PC players to enjoy this iconic title with awesome enhancements. The ability to boost resolution, eliminate frame rate limitations, and improve overall performance breathes new life into the game. While a powerful CPU is necessary to fully appreciate the experience, the result is undeniably worth the investment. With RPCS3's main build incorporating previous specialized improvements, the time has never been better to embark on this unforgettable journey once again. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like and subscribe for more videos like this. If you want to get in touch with me, you can follow me on Twitter. I mean X, I guess. Anyway, thanks for watching and I'll see you on the next one.
Snake, it's my turn to protect you.